Thank you, Dr. Vishwanath Kurvi and Dr. Nagaraj Gowda and Dr. Ramakant Kulkarni for this opportunity to meet all of you online and contribute to this very important webinar. I'm very happy to share this webinar with other distinguished speakers and very happy to see Professor Deekshit here. I think we are lucky to have you for a while in the Hubli and Dharwar, and it's a great opportunity to spend some time with you. We also had a good occasion a few days back, and very happy to see you and to see you amongst us. The future of our students is very dear to all of us, and therefore we are discussing such an important topic. And I believe such discussions and brainstorming sessions will help us to anticipate challenges and prepare well. I think the program for today is roughly, 15-20 minutes for each of us. And then subject to time, we can all take some questions as well. So without taking too much of time, let me come straight to the subject. As we all know, the health of the economy is a key factor to understand the employment scenario. And when there is a recession, as being experienced currently, unemployment rises. As it is, we did have about 7-8% unemployment before the current scenario, which began, let's say, by March. Because what happens in a recession of the kind that we are experiencing today, the demand for products and services across industries falls, therefore revenue falls, but fixed costs remain more or less the same, and therefore businesses get into losses. And business failure or business loss leads again to job losses. And when there is a salary cut or when there is a job loss, consumer demand and also business demand drops further. And actually it becomes a kind of a vicious circle, and we will actually not know where we have to begin a corrective action. India's GDP for the last about 5 years has been steadily falling from about 7-8%. Last year, we came down to about 4%. And we just got the figures that for the period ending June, that is this year, the first quarter of this year, the GDP has fallen to minus 23.9%. So minus 23.9% is our GDP for this year's first quarter, which means we are really in trouble. However, it's not that only India is in trouble, so also is other economies, though we really can't say it's a consolation. We live in a globalized world, and the drop in GDP in Europe, US, is ranging around about 10-12%. However, the drop in GDP in India at minus 23.9% is almost one of the sharpest drops in the GDP. Now, if we had to see how we are going to fare the current year or the year after this, there is no very reliable projections just now. However, the situation that we are in today is highly dynamic, but some of the projections that we have from IMF is that next year, that is the current year, sorry, that is 2020-21, for the year that is ending March, emerging markets and developing economies, there is an expectation that the GDP may come to about 5% or so. However, this is an overall situation. This is an overall situation, and many of us, we expect, considering that, you know, we have had minus 23.9% in one fourth of the year, we are expecting that we will have roughly around minus 10% drop in GDP for the complete year. So let's see what implications we have on the campus recruitments. The first thing is, this is a extremely unusual year. And what we know is, roughly about 40% of startup companies have shut down or are on the verge of closing down. There are job cuts across industries, and during this pandemic, an estimated 18.9 million people have lost jobs. That's nearly about 2 crore people have lost jobs across many sectors put together. This is in addition to lakhs of people who are on leave without pay. And then there are salary cuts, which are ranging from 15 to 80%. 15 to 80% salary cuts has been experienced. Of course, 80% is for those people who are the highest level in an organization, but this is the range, you know, 15 to 80% is the salary drops. So on an average, one can safely say that about 20-30% salary cuts has been experienced. The other factor that we have to remember in our today's context is, all those who are recruited in 2019 campus placement have not joined for the reasons of logistics and the current pandemic. So what I feel is, this year we might expect, or we might experience, what we call a double whammy effect this year. What it means is, two major negative factors. One is, business is down, we have seen up to June, and with any improvement, even in the current quarter ending this month, or even the next two quarters, the GDP is still going to be negative territory for the entire year. This is one. The second, now more people are available on the job market. We have to remember that there are a lot of people now in the job market compared to any other situation that we have seen in the past. So what does it mean? It means we have more supply and less demand for this year's campus recruitment. However, how do we see the prognosis for rest of the year? We have indications that we have opened industries now. Businesses have slowly begun. So we have some indication now as to what are the sectors of the economy where there is a kind of a positive vibe is there. And slowly, these are the industries which are coming back on the growth path. So what are those industries which are on growth path, coming back to doing their normal business, and who are likely to have, you know, some decent growth for the year? One is IT and ITES sector. Second is biotech. Third is pharma sector. Fourth is healthcare. Then we have e-commerce. Then we have FMCG business. See, one good thing about FMCG, or essential FMCG, not the entire FMCG, but essential FMCG, is that irrespective of the market situation, FMCG, since it deals with all our normal living essentials, the business is not so badly affected, even in a recession like what we're experiencing now. So FMCG sector, there will be recruitments happening. Then we have agro and agrochemicals. This year has been phenomenally good so far with a very good monsoon. So agro and agrochemical sector is likely to do very well. Then we have educational services. Educational services like institutions, plus also edutech, you know, technology companies in the education sector. Now, these are some of the major sectors which are likely to do quite okay this year. So what are the sectors that are not likely to do so well? So that, you know, the idea of giving this kind of a background is that we have a lot of people from various institutions, and we are trying to see where our efforts should be there, what we should be doing, because what we did last year may not work this year. So the sectors which are not likely to do very well this year, one is manufacturing. Of course, not the entire manufacturing, but all those sectors where there is a manufacturing, and the sectors where the growth is not likely to be very good. And these are the sectors which will take a lot of time to recover. So the first one here is automobile sector. I know a lot of our students get into automobile sector. Automobile sector is going to take some time to get back on the growth path. So there are, for example, these are the kind of ancillaries who are supplying to automobile industries, manufacturing. So like this, there will be a lot of sectors related to manufacturing who will not do well. So other than manufacturing, automobile, then the hospitality industry, airlines, property and construction. Then there is a very important sector where our students are going, which is called the BFIA, that is banking, finance, insurance sector. Electronics and appliances. Electronic appliances, there will be some companies in India which will do well because of the current ban on, or the focus on, you know, make in India, and the initiative which are being taken against some of the Chinese companies. So there is a good possibility that Indian companies in this sector might do well, but overall electronics and appliances is not likely to do very well. Then of course there is you know, luxury products and brands. So these are some of those sectors which are not likely to do well this year. So does it mean that this year is going to be a washout? Obviously no, because we have started hearing for the last about a month or so major recruitment plans by sectors and by certain companies also. Some of the important recruitment announcements which have been made in the last few weeks. One is Amazon. Amazon has announced plans to recruit about 70,000 people. Now that's a huge number. Then there is TCS, who have announced 40,000 freshers. They have plans to recruit about 40,000 freshers. Then there is HCL, about 15,000. There is a announcement very recently from State Bank of India that they have announced a VRS scheme under which about 30,000 people are likely to take the benefit of the VRS scheme. And SBI has announced 14,000 fresh recruitments. Now, these are some names I'm giving because not all the names, not all the recruitments are in media. So one can safely presume that competing brands will be also in a similar mode. So for example, if Amazon is taking 70,000, we can safely presume that other e-commerce companies like Flipkart and the rest, they will also have some recruitments. So what it means that we lost about 6 months, let's say, in this current financial year, and slowly we are coming back to a kind of a normal situation. So what are the other sectors which are shown intention to hire? Now, earlier I mentioned about those sectors which have or which are on the growth path. Now I'm going to give you some indication about which sectors, what is the kind of a recruitment mood in the country. This is based on a survey done recently. And as per that, now healthcare and pharma sector, 21% of the companies said that they will start recruitments. healthcare and pharma, about 21% of the companies said they will start the recruitment. Then there is an industry called KPO, that is knowledge process outsourcing. About 20% of the companies said they would like to start recruitment. Then there is e-commerce and technology startup. For example, like Amazon, the number I gave you just now, about 18% companies said they will start recruitment. Then there's educational services, about 17%. Telecom, 15%. IT, 15%. Then there is FMCG retail, that is essential FMCG, 14%. Agriculture and agrochemicals, 13%. And general FMCG, 12%. Then there is power and energy, 10%. So I have given an indication of what sectors we should be focusing. And even in a recession, it is not that all the companies are doing bad. Even in certain sectors where the whole industry is doing bad or has had challenges, there are companies which will always be, there are companies which can move against the tide and do something which is different, do something which is out of the box. For example, we know that Hindustan Unilever has not cut any jobs, and they're also going to have salary hikes. There are promotions being planned. And then there are companies like Bharat Pay. It's a payment app company, and they are going to go for recruitments. So what this means is, even in a sector which may not be bad, for example, manufacturing. We know manufacturing is not doing very well this year. It does not mean that all the companies in manufacturing will be doing bad. So there is a principle we always need to remember. The principle is, from a very general example, you cannot come to a specific conclusion. And from a very specific example, you cannot come to a general conclusion. So what it means is, whatever information we have today with us and whatever information we are sharing today, the analysis and conclusion must be drawn by us according to our requirements. Now, we have spoken about certain sectors which are going to do well and certain sectors which are going to take a much longer time to recover. Now, this survey also indicated what are the cities where we need to focus for campus recruitment, and what is the mood in different cities across the country. So the cities to focus in Bangalore, about 21% of the companies in Bangalore said they would like to start recruitments. In Delhi, about 19% of the companies said they would like to start recruitments. Hyderabad was 15%. Chandigarh was 14%. Calcutta was 12%. And Bombay also was 12%. Now, what it means here is, in a challenging period that we are currently in, when we start focusing on our efforts, the sectors and the cities, a combination of all that is a good way to change our strategy for the coming year. However, it does not mean that there is no scope in Chennai or nobody will recruit in Chennai or Ahmedabad. That's not the scene. But these are general indications for us as to how we should be moving ahead. So, what are the implications for campus recruitments for this year? So as we said earlier, there is going to be more supply and less demand. So what are the implications? Of course, all these things will be covered in detail by other colleagues, but I'm just the last points I'm making now. What we can expect is campus recruitments will be or can be delayed. Campus recruitment may be more online to begin with. Companies will be more selective on recruitments, and importantly, will be difficult this year to place average candidates, especially those who are very weak in communication. So we must make sure that the students realize that their skills have to be more refined, because in a telephonic interview, you need a different kind of skills, or you need more refined skills than as compared to a personal interview. It also means that not only students, all of us need to adapt ourselves to the new scenario, and salary levels may go down, or at best, it will remain at last year's level, because every company's bottom line, even the top line and therefore the bottom line, is under pressure. So given the circumstances, what do we do? A few points I have for how we must be looking at a way forward. The first thing is, each institution in our own situation, we need to have a new strategy, because what worked last year for us may not work this year. Secondly, our communication, networking, and PR skills will be really a test. Third, we have to really hard sell our USP, our respective USP. Why should somebody come to our institution? What is so special in our institution or our students? So we need to identify our USP, and we need to really hard sell that. And the students must be explained about today's reality. I was very happy to see that survey, the outcome of that survey, which Dr. Gowdam was mentioning. So we need to educate the mindset of students, and we need to accept jobs, where they're available. One may be tempted to work in, where their parents are there, and near to the institutions or where they're currently there. But it's a good idea today to accept jobs as they're available, because in 6-7 months time, the new campus recruitment will begin for next year, and there will be more competition in the coming year. So it may be a good idea to educate our students and ensure that they have a different mindset and accept what is really available in this year. And the other important thing that I think we have to educate our students is that there you might be getting them placements, but their performance on the job is extremely going to be important and monitored very continuously. So they have to prove their worth on the job to retain those jobs that you might get them this year. And if there are students who are still doing some kind of a project, submitting reports, etc., to those companies where they have done some projects, then they must make a lot of efforts and take those projects and those project reports seriously, because there's a good possibility that those companies where students are doing projects, there could be jobs available. And I do hope that we are able to make some online and offline training plans for our students, especially pre-placement training, and ensure that they have all the necessary primary skills like personality, communication, interpersonal skills, self-confidence, time management, etc. And also the job-specific skills, depending on what they are getting in marketing. Yes?
Thank you. A lot of information has been shared, sir. And then we have a question and answer session at that time or something.
Yeah. So I'm just closing now. Our strategy and our preparation and mentoring students with a pre-placement training, I think, will be the key for this year. So the other speakers will be talking about some of the other subjects in detail, after which we can always have an interaction, question and answer session. So thank you all for your time. And we will continue this interaction after all the other speakers have finished. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, sir. I think you have very good lot of information taken from the areas and covering almost all the which of the areas have got placements and then many of the persons in this area, there's a lot of insights about that. Thank you very much.